6th September, CSIR celebrated its 80th Foundation Day function, graced by the august presence of Honorable Vice President of India, Shri M. Venkaiah Naidu Ji. This webinar series we are conducting on weekly basis is a way to mark the milestones of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav and CSIR at 80 by showcasing success stories from different CSIR laboratories. Today's webinar is on coating technology to mitigate corrosion of rebars in concrete structures. The technology is named as cement polymer composite coating system and is developed by one of the CSIR laboratories situated in Karaikudi, Tamil Nadu, the Central Electrochemical Research Institute, very famously known as SICRI. CSIR SICRI is the largest research establishment for electrochemistry in South Asia and serves as a launching pad for a magnitude of technologies for Indian electrochemical industries. The institute works on the research and technological interventions covering almost all aspects of electrochemical science and technology, ranging from corrosion science and engineering, electrochemical materials engineering, electrochemical power sources, nanoscale electrochemistry, and various other disciplines. So for knowing more about that laboratory and particularly its cement polymer composite coating system, which is the focus today, we are joined with esteemed speakers for the webinar, Dr. N. Kalai Selvi, Director CSIR SICRI, Senior Principal Scientist from CSIR SICRI, Dr. R. Vedalakshmi, and the collaborators, Shri Hemang Bajurkar from God Trading Company, Mumbai, and Shri S. Shahul Hamid, Protector Anti-Corrosives, Chennai. I am Dr. Shikha with you, your host and scientist from Science Communication Directorate at CSIR Headquarters, and I welcome you all for the webinar today. So we have with us Dr. N. Kalai Selvi, who has taken over the charge as Director CSIR SICRI since February 2019. Dr. Kalai Selvi is PhD in chemistry from Annamalai University. Her research work of more than 25 years is primarily focused on electrochemical power systems and in particular, development of electrode materials, custom design synthesis methods, optimization of reaction parameters and electrochemical evaluation of in-house prepared electrode materials for their suitability in energy storage device assembly. Dr. Kalai Selvi is a recipient of many prestigious awards, including the MRSI Medal, CSIR Raman Research Fellowship, INSA NRF Exchange Award, Brain Pool Fellowship of Korea, and the Most Inspiring Woman Scientist Award. So we shall start with the opening remarks by Director CSIR SICRI, Dr. N. Kalai Selvi. Over to you, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you, Shika. Good afternoon and namaskar to every one of you. I'm here as Director of Central Electrochemical Research Institute, which is the very unique institute doing research in the field of very unique field of electrochemical science and technology. We are very proud to say that we are one among the 37 national laboratories under the aegis of CSIR, our parent organization, the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, wherein R&D is being taken care in every discipline of science, be it physical science, chemical science, engineering science, material science, marine science, and whatnot. Similarly, few other labs like us, we are working on very, very unique fields. So some labs are working on mining research, somebody is working on petroleum research, and somebody on food research, somebody on leather research, and we are here with electrochemical science and technology. When the whole country and when the globe, entire globe is now talking about zero carbon technologies, zero emission technologies, green technologies, yes, we are there with all green technologies, because electrochemical technologies, we are ensuring the entire world that the entire electrochemical technology is a zero emission technology. Nothing is evolved to the atmosphere, and therefore nowadays there is a great deal of interest and there is a great deal of search that is going on in a very big way for electrochemical science and technologies. And we do live up to the expectation, and we are escalating ourselves to the maximum possible extent of addressing the requirements of this society, be it for its domestic office, are for its strategic applications, are for its very unique applications. So in that particular way, like the way Dr. Shikha mentioned and narrated so beautifully, we are working on six different verticals, and a major vertical is corrosion prevention and monitoring. And the second vertical is on electrochemical power systems division. Third one is on industrial metal finishing. Fourth one is on process engineering. And the fifth one is on mainly on electro-organic and materials electrochemistry. And of course, our sixth one is our satellite center in Chennai, wherein we are doing a lot of work on batteries and fuel cells. So with this kind of a basic arrangement, we are celebrating, along with our CSIR headquarters, the 80th glorifying year of CSIR's great accomplishments and the 75th Independence Day of this nation with few of our technologies. And I think this is the right time. We as Sikriyans should also feel so proud, and we take this opportunity to reach every one of you, mainly to reach the unreached part of this country through this particular forum, by means of which we are able to give you what we do, especially in the field of corrosion protection or corrosion mitigation. Special thanks to CSIR, because through this window, I think we will be able to very effectively reach the unreached portion of this society. Coming to this corrosion, because all other areas, I'm not going to talk about it today. Today is a day for corrosion, celebrating our accomplishments in the area of corrosion monitoring and especially corrosion mitigation. And as all of you know, India is one such country where in all the three sides we are surrounded by seawater. So it's a large coastal area. It is the coastal belt of India is so huge. And therefore, whatever structure is built in this country, there is always a threat because of this marine environment. Be it whether the corrosion due to chlorine or due to sulfate or due to carbonate or due to moisture or due to oxygen or due to any kind of a pollutant, definitely, if the original life of the structure is claimed as 75 to 100 years, just because of this marine environment driven corrosion, its lifetime is reduced to the tune of 10 to 15 years. So this is where the entire Indian community, especially the industries, they approached us long time back, whether we can do something through electrochemical science and technology. This is how our corrosion mitigation efforts started. We started our first version with cement slurry coating, which was coated over the rebar to mitigate this corrosion. Then we came up with the second version, that is 2.0, that is only called cement polymer composite coating. So here also the cement polymer composite coating is mainly applied on the rebars. And from the same division of corrosion monitoring and mitigation, we have many other successful technologies. I could say that it is an inhibitor solution, or it's a four-coat system, or a moisture compatible coating. There are a variety of technologies which could be really applied to increase the life of any structure, of which today we are going to see the main technology, which is called a cement polymer composite coating technology, for which the response was so huge, not only 10, 15 years back, even today. And Dr. Shikha, we are so proud to say that this is one such technology. Even last week, we transferred this technology to a new client. And many of the clients who already got this technology from us, they are approaching us repeatedly to renew the license. So this is the way it is getting endorsed that this CPCC technology is really a celebrated technology. It is finding its application even today for its current scenario, for its sustainable application. And this is where we are so proud to offer you the details of CPCC technology to you as well as to the entire nation, I would say. So to give more details in this particular respect, we have with us the inventor, who is already involved in this technology. Dr. Vedalakshmi is there. And we are having two potential clients, one Mr. Shahul and another Mr. Hemang. They are also joining us and they'll be giving other details. So with these few words, once again, I thank my parent organization, CSIR, the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, Dr. Shikha, as well as the other members involved, and especially Dr. Geethamani Rayasam. And thank you so much. And along with you, I also wish to enjoy the talk by Dr. Vedalakshmi and the other two clients. Thank you, Shiga. Over to you.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for such a warm welcome. And rather, I would say the enthusiastic welcome to the audience and our speakers today. And it was very nice to have a brief overview of the laboratory and the work of unique work, as you said, of electrochemical technology on which the laboratory is working. So also you briefed about the technology of cement polymer composite coating, its application and its importance and impact in the country. So thank you once again, ma'am. We shall now move to our speakers to know more about the technology, its development process, significance, and the application areas. So the first speaker for the webinar is Dr. R. Vedalakshmi, Senior Principal Scientist at CSIR SIKRI. Dr. R. Vedalakshmi is PhD in Civil Engineering from Anna University. Her research area of specialization lies in the field of corrosion monitoring and control in concrete structures. As an inventor, she has been associated in developing technologies related to corrosion control of reinforced and pre-stressed concrete structures in marine environment. Dr. Vedalakshmi has received NACE Corrosion Awareness Award of 2014 for meritorious contribution in the field of corrosion science and technology, and the Vishwakarma Award of 2015 for her outstanding scientific contributions. So with this, I invite Dr. Vedalakshmi to kindly inform us more about the cement polymer composite coating technology of CSIR SIKRI. Over to you, ma'am.
Yeah, Shika, thank you so much. Dr. Vedalakshmi is now uploading her slides. So that will take half a minute. I just want to share one more information. Many of our people, including you, you'd have many times traveled up to Ramanathapuram and Rameshwaram. So there you would have seen one Pomban bridge, and that Pomban bridge is having two of our technology-based coatings. Inside we have the CSC coating, cement slurry coating, and outside we have the four coat system. So this is a live example, living example, where CSIR SIKRI's corrosion protection technologies are getting implemented. Thanks a lot. Now the slides are up. I think the slide is visible. Am I right, Shika?
Yeah, slides are visible.
Yeah. Yes, madam. Thank you, ma'am, for your brief introduction and as well as the about the technology. Now I am directly pass on to my presentation, that is coating technology to mitigate corrosion of rebars in concrete structures. In general, the structures, the causes of deterioration of structures is classified under various heading, such as technological is 42%, constructional is 22%, structural 12%, overloading 3%, and due to foundation failure 7%, accidents 4%, and the collapse, which results the collapse of the structures, it may happen. Like example, Thanagiri Bridge in Mumbai, Goa Bridge in Mandovi Bridge in Goa. So which leads to collapse of the structures. So these the consequences of the corrosion in real structures are steel and concrete. Steel is reduced in the reduction of rebar area, which reduces mechanical properties such as ductility, which is very important during its service of the structures. And concrete cracking observed, which ultimately reduces the strength of the concrete. So loss in concrete integrity. Both of things, the deterioration phenomena occurs in steel and concrete, ultimately reduces the bond of the concrete, bond as well as the overall load carrying capacity of the structure, which ultimately leads to reduction of serviceability of the structures. So from this flow chart, we came to understand the corrosion, which reduces our life of all our infrastructures, in which we are spending huge amount of money every year. So the cost of corrosion, it is estimated, it is around 5-7% of the GDP. Now we are going to see how this corrosion is occurred in concrete structures. The elements required for this occurrence, this is the anode, cathode, electrolyte, and oxygen. The anode is the site of rust formation on the rebar, where the anode is, maybe it may be the rod present very near to the cover or present in the cracked concrete. Cathode is the area the reaction is supported. This anodic reaction is supported. It may be the nearby or is it very far away? The rebar, which is far away from the cover concrete, is act as a cathode. The electrolyte is nothing but it is a concrete which contains moisture as well as chloride. The chloride is from diffused from the seawater. So oxygen is already present inside the concrete because concrete is a lot of pores. So through this pores, air permeated through that, air and moisture. From that, the oxygen availability is more. So the loss of this passive film due to the presence of chloride ions, more than 0.6 to 0.87, kg per meter cube, is caused as corrosion of rebars. Another pollutant is called a loss of alkalinity by carbonation, that is mainly due to carbon dioxide. In the case of industrial marine environment, when CO2 fall on the concrete surface, which causes reduction of pH. So the mechanism in real structures by forming the microcell as well as macrocell corrosion of rebar, the corrosion is occurred. Microcell corrosion means both anode and cathodes are inseparable. The distance is very less. It's almost zero. Whereas in macrocell corrosion, the distance between the anode and the cathode, it may be a few centimeters. Corrosion in structures, as I already told, it manifests in three ways. One is chloride-induced corrosion, another one is carbonation, and sulfate attack. Sulfate is present in either in seawater or ground or any other form. So due to chloride-induced corrosion, the rust, that is iron oxide, which is 7 times in volume, it increases because the density is very less, which exerts pressure which is more than the tensile strength of the concrete, causing spalling of concrete as shown in photograph. Similarly, carbonation is occurred due to the presence of carbon dioxide in the case of industrial marine environment. So when carbon dioxide, when the air comes fall on the concrete surface, in presence of moisture, it forms carbonic acid. This calcium hydroxide present inside the concrete react with this carbonic acid, forms calcium carbonate. This calcium carbonate causes the reduction of pH, which is normally in good concrete, it is normally from 12 to 13, which reduces due to this carbonation. This pH is reduces to 8 to 9. This reduced carbon, the most drawback is even a small amount of chloride causes the corrosion initiation. Sources of another pollutant is sulfate. So sulfate maybe comes from seawater or groundwater. Oxidation of sulfate minerals present in the clay adjacent to the concrete structures, and anaerobic bacteria present also present in the soil also produces the H2SO4. So tricalcium sulfate present in the concrete react with the sulfate present in the seawater. Say for example, seawater, either MgSO4 or calcium sulfate along with the CaOH2. Always the CaOH2 is free. Large amount of CaOH2 available in concrete microstructure. So it is readily react with any pollutants come inside. For example, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, chlorides, as well as sulfates. And it forms calcium sulfoaluminate, which is the increase in volume, not able to accommodate inside the microstructure and causes cracks, which is shown in the photographs. So these effects, as I already told, depletion of CaOH2, that is, it is consumed. This by this reaction, this CaOH2 is consumed. So naturally, the pH of the concrete get reduced. And calcification, decalcification of CHS, calcium silicate hydrate, is the main binding agent towards the contribution of strength. Concrete is, as you already we already aware, concrete is strong in compression. Though so, this decalcification ultimately reduces the strength of the concrete as well as introduces the cracks. These cracks further promotes the corrosion process. So again, coating options, various methods available in our country to protect the structures in this marine environment for so use of corrosion resistant bars. It is available CRS. It is commonly known as the CRS rebars. Application, all industry, by adding this corrosion resistant rebar is nothing but adding corrosion resistant elements such as silicon, phosphate, chromium. Mainly chromium is added to provide corrosion resistant. Application of protective coating to reinforcing steel, in this category only we developed, and my talk is going on CPC. So application of protective coating to concrete surface is another way, and addition of inhibitors admixtures. In India, there are three types of coatings available in market. One is our coating, that is cement polymer composite coating, which is known as most of the engineers, they are known. It is as a CPCC, which is passivating cum barrier type of coating. Another one is fusion bonded epoxy coating, which is only barrier coating. And continuous hot dip as well as continuous galvanizing, which is a metallic coating. Compared to the CPCC, galvanized reinforcement by the way of sacrificial production, as it is and it is performance is pH dependent. Particularly in the case of concrete, it is preferentially corrode because of high pH. Whereas another fusion bonded epoxy coating, it is propensity to damage during handling. If it, any small damage is present on the coating, it causes under film corrosion as well as undercutting effect also. So patch repair, because which this fusion bonded epoxy coating is a factory made process which is solvent free epoxy. So patch repairs at the site on the damages occurred during the construction practices is repaired with the liquid epoxy, which is a different composition when compared to the parent coatings. So the adhesion variation causes also reduces the performance. These two drawbacks widely used that is in the existing coating system widely adopted in our country is overcome by the CPCC. This cement polymer composite coating consists of two coats. One is primer and sealing coat. So the method of application of coating system is initially the rebar, corroded rebar shall be cleaned with this shall be using abrasive either sand or other grit blasting as the SSPC procedures, SP10 procedure. Then after within 4 hours of thorough surface cleaning, the primer is applied. After 30 minutes, the primer application sealing coat was applied. Which is this primer, that novelty of this primer is it is a rapid curing property it is having. So it will get cured within 30 minutes. So the entire coating system, the two coats we can apply it within 12 hours from to 24 hours or on the day itself. So advantages is CPC had rapid curing property, as I told, that is the primer is having a novel property. We are tailoring that property because of this, it is for mechanization. It possesses adequate bendability characteristics because there is the acrylic polymer we selected. It is having the such a novel bendability characteristics. We can coat the rebar and bend. That is the main advantages over the existing coating system. Being cement-based composition, it is more compatible in concrete medium because it is having more alkaline, high alkaline resistance as well as bond strength is not get affected. It is passivating barrier type of coating because in the primer, which is having the pigment, which is having amine-based, so it acts as inhibitors. So any defects in the coating may not lead to severe undercutting, whereas this is the main problem in the case of fusion bonded epoxy coating. Damages in the coating can be easily repaired using the same coating formulation. The coating has high corrosion resistance against chlorides as well as CO2. It is this commercialization, this coating we developed during the year 92-93 and Indian patents granted 2001 and 2004. Technology has been transferred to 15 licensees and 3 licensees renewed the license for 2 times. More than 3 lakh tons of steel have been treated using this technology so far. So we under laboratory conditions, we evolved the corrosion resistance and finally arrived the how much service life is enhanced by using these coatings. Test as per ASTM standard, rapid macrocell corrosion. As I already told in structures, there are the possibility of formation of corrosion for under rebar. Macrocell corrosion is more prevalent. And marine exposure studies, bond strength between coated rod and evaluation of corrosion resistance under cracked conditions, evaluation of with corrosion resistance with the damages on coated rebars, corrosion resistance in chlorate concrete under alternate wetting and drying test, which is very important test, which simulates this flash on condition of the marine environment. Because in the marine environment, there is the splash zone condition is the worst, very highest corrosion rate compared to the immersion as well as atmospheric zone. So whatever be the coating technology we have we developed is we actually tested in this splash zone condition so as to it can be take care of in the atmospheric zone as well as the immersion zone condition. So as per AISTM standard, the requirements of laid down by the AISTM for the rebar coating is plane thickness, bendability, abrasion resistance, chemical resistance, 2 volts impressed voltage test, and the FAMAS salt fog test in 5% NaCl solution. So that is cement polymer coated rods satisfy all the requirements, because even abrasion resistance, the loss in weight is 90 grams, whereas it requires 100 milligrams. This is very important test for handling, because our coated rebar, it must have sufficient resistance against handling stresses as well as during the construction practices. So as to it can the damages on the coated rebars will be very less. So chemical resistance means it should have a concrete microstructure, which is a very high pH, and also through the cracks a very high amount of fluoride is permeated through the concrete. So 3 molar, it is tested under 3-4 major four environments. It is distilled water, calcium chloride, hydroxide, and the sodium and calcium hydroxide. So at the end of 45 days, there shall not on the coated rebars, there is no discoloration and disbondment. Similarly, 2 volts impressed voltage test, which is the also an important, determined to know the corrosion resistance as well as the adhesion of the coating. Simultaneously, we can test by using the single single test. All these 5 tests, it can be conducted at the site. We need not have sufficient knowledge on corrosion. Just we can have as per procedure, ISTM standard, or you can have from the CZRA code of practice, you can conduct the test. So salt fog test, which is a very standard test. So at the end of 90 days, there is no rust spots, whereas at the end of 120 days, that is 4 months, the total rust initiated is, which is only 0.03% of total surface exposed area, which is admissible by the corrosion engineers. This is the bendability test, which is the first photograph shows the bending of coated rebar. That is, you can observe, it is showed at site also. There is no crack on the bars. Similarly, it is bended bars in actual structures. Then in marine coatings, in marine conditions, it is also tested in marine atmosphere, which is having the temporary relative humidity. That is the CCRA corrosion testing center at Mandapam, which is also our unit, SICRIS unit, for testing atmospheric corrosion of all our corrosion technologies. The salinity, which is having a very high salinity level of 2.709 milligram per dm squared per day. If the coating is sustained under this marine environment, it will sustain anywhere in India. So the corrosion rate compared with our coatings with the FBEC, which is also widely used in India, is compared with the uncoated rebar, that is 500D TMT, TMT CRS. TMT CRS means the corrosion resistant rebars. So the comparison is between uncoated and coated rebar. Whereas in the case of uncoated rebar, the failure may be occurred if the corrosion rate is more than 8 microns per year. The service life is only 10 to 15 years. Whereas in the case of CPCC and FBC, no corrosion damage expected. That is the requirement of any coating system on the rebar. Our coating CPCC fulfilled that requirement. The potential static test in a 10% chloride solution, which is a very important test, where we have to fix the potential either at 200 or 300 millivolts. Various procedures, various potential was used to measure the corrosion current, where researchers reported 1.42 microns per cm squared is the corrosion current density. If it is more than, it causes the failure. So all uncoated rebars which starts to corrode between 100 to 200 hours, whereas up to 650 hours, both the CPCC and FBEC, the corrosion current density is less than 0.1 microns per cm squared. So rapid macro cell corrosion as a more prevalent form of corrosion, as we discussed in structures. So in simulated concrete pour solution, that is with this 15% of chloride solution, we conducted that test. Whereas in one which is the rock which is kept immersed in chloride solution, in the presence of chloride solution, this rod will act as a anode, whereas in the absence of chloride, the bath immersed in absence of chloride, medium containing absence of chloride will act as cathode. So by forming, these two are connected through a resistor, 100 ohms, and the current was measured. From this, corrosion rate was calculated. So for all the types of, that is a TF500, DCTD, as well as a CRS, TMT, and a CPCC, where the corrosion is more in the case of uncoated bar, where it is very less, that is less than 2 microns per year for the coated rebars. Another one is potential dynamic polarization test, which is very, very important test to assess how much chloride which can the coated rebars can able to resist. In the case of CRS, which is widely used in our country, where which is having only 0.58 to 0.9% chloride by weight of cement, there is a CPCC which is having 4 to 3%. Similarly, FBC also 4 to 7%, which is 7 times more than that of TMT rebars. Bond strength, studies on bond strength, the relative bond strength, because which is very equally important as corrosion resistance test, because when concrete is strong in compression but weak in tension, that's why we provide rod inside the steel rod inside the structures to take a tensile stress. When tensile strength of the concrete exceeds, the rod will take the tensile stress. This the transfer of load from the concrete to steel only occurred through this bond. That is, it is mere frictional and additional force. So this bond is actually uncoated rebar, which is having a roughened surface, which is naturally which is having more bond strength. But when it is coated with any coating material, the ribs of the depth of the ribs is provided on the rebar may get reduced slightly may get reduced. It may causes reduction of bond strength. So we have, for any coating before embedding inside the concrete structure, we have to test the bond test, which is very, very important test from the structural point of view. So by coated rebar, which is embedded in, which is centrally embedded as shown in photograph, which is pulled, the load is pulled centrally, and the dial cage was fixed at the other end, which is monitored the slip of the rebar. So load versus slip is drawn, and from this at 0.25 mm slip, the bond strength was calculated. From this bond strength, we conducted this test for different thickness of the coatings, from starts from 175 to 380 microns to arrive the minimum thickness, which should not affect the bond strength of the coating, and also bond strength of the concrete. And also we tested two different type of patterns. The first one is where the per unit length, the number of ribs are more. Whereas in the case of this bar, where the number of ribs are very less. These are generally rip formations on the rebars in our country, available in our country. So this is from the graph, it is clearly shows up to 230 microns, there is no reduction in bond. That is both coated and uncoated bar, which is having the similar bond strength. When the coating thickness is increased more than 230 only, there is a reduction in bond strength. But whereas in the case of ribs, there is a reduction in bond strength. So the preferable rib pattern is number of per unit length, the ribs will be more. So during service, the durability of the coating may be reduced. during after embedding. This is before embedding. We assessed the coating of the rebars as per an international standards, as well as other test methods we normally we used in our to assess any protective method, any protection methods we used, we evaluated, which shows a higher durability factor. After embedding inside the concrete, crack may occurs. During the construction practice, damage may present on the coating. Presence of a higher amount of chloride may diffuse inside the concrete during service. Now we will see what will happen if it is if the rebars performed in cracked concrete. So at 0.2, 0.1 mm crack width, this uncoated rebar shows, that is photograph shows very severe corrosion, whereas coated rebar, there is no corrosion. Whereas in the case of crack width, 0.2 mm to 0.2 to 2 mm, uncoated rebar shows very severe corrosion, whereas coated rebar, which shows just a rust initiated, which is permissible. In the case of alternate wetting and drying test, that is splash zone, which simulates splash zone condition, which is the environmental chamber where we can simulate the required RH and the temperature. So in this, we exposed all and we conduct this test at a particular RH and temperature. Then we break open the specimen after 10 seconds of exposure without added chloride. That is, only CTD rebars shows a rust initiation, whereas other TMT bars, that is particularly CRS, also having a good resistance. Whereas in the case of 1% chloride added concrete, other rebars get corroded, whereas only CPCC, it performs better. It is in the present, that is, we made a damage on the coating intentionally to the surface of to the exposed area of 1% and 2%, and evaluated its corrosion resistance. After some exposure period, both the coatings, that is CPCC, showed better performance. From the photographs, we can visually see. Similarly, the test, the coated bath under stressed conditions, it is coated on precessing steel and it is stressed and exposed to the atmospheric. After 18 months of exposure, CPCC coated strand shows good resistance, whereas uncoated bath shows severe corrosion. So from this, how much by giving the coating, we quantified this enhancement of the service life by applying after adopting a suitable model. Whereas in the time to initiation by adopting chloride diffusion model, we evolved, as well as during propagation, the TP, that is time to propagation, is evolved by Modway model. So by adding TA and TP, service life was arrived for 15 as well as 25 mm concrete. Uncoated rebar, which shows less than 10 years, whereas CPCC and coated rebar shows 40 to 80 years. So from this slides, we can visually see that is, it is 4 to 8 times the durability is increased. Actually, our aim of this structures in marine environment, because most of them are strategic structures aimed for 80 to 100 years. So CPCC coated rebars, when we used in structures, marine structures, which increases the service life up to 80 to 100 years. So which these are the various projects implement, our technology has been implemented. These are the visuals in action. So, I can conclude that this CPCC system is increased the durability by 4 to 8 times from the in the marine environment, from 10 to service life, from 10 to 15 years to 80 to 100 years. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your talk and giving us such a detailed information about the occurrence of corrosion, how it costs to our GDP, and the technology developed by CSIR SICRI to mitigate it through the CPCC system. So which is in fact one popularly known technology for corrosion resistance in India. So thank you once again. We'll move to our next speakers, who are the collaborators and stakeholders of CSIR SICRI and have been utilizing this coating technology for years together. We'll start with Shri Hemang Bajurkar ji, who is proprietor of Gaur Trading Company, Mumbai. Mr. Bajurkar is graduate in economics and is involved basically in the profession of coatings and anti-corrosive products. The Gold Trading Company, under his leadership, has obtained the CPCC license from CSIR SICRI during 2006 and have utilized the technology in treating more than 1 lakh ton of steel for various projects since then. So with this, I invite Mr. Bajurkar to inform us more about their collaboration with CSIR SICRI and the utilization of the of this technology. Over to you, Hemang Bajurkar ji.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak on this platform. And thank you, Dr. Ved Lakshmi, for having guided us all these years. We have been taken the license for cement powder composite coating for in 2006, and we have renewed it ever since. We have been very satisfied with it. Concrete is the basic structure of concrete is the basic item of any structure, and steel is the lifeline of concrete itself. So to protect the steel, lots of different systems have been used.
Sir, in the background, somebody is talking. Sir, in your background, somebody is talking.
Hello. Is it okay? Okay, so many different systems have been used, like stainless steel has been used. We have used CRS steel, galvanized steel has been used. Also, different coatings have been used, like fusion bonded epoxy or cement inhibitor solution, etc. Cement polymer composite coating is a unique system that was developed in the 90s. And CSIRI has guided us, all license holders, since then to provide good service to the construction industry in these close to about 20 to 25 years. We ourselves have coated close to about 1 lakh tons of steel, and we hope to do many more tons in the future also. As far as the CPCC system is concerned, this itself is the rusted steel that has to be treated.
Himangji, are you moving the slides? It's yes. Not moving here.
It is not moving there.
Actually, he should have made it as a slideshow. Only then it will be easy for you to move the slides.
Please go to slideshow mode.
Slideshow mode. If you give me a minute or so, please.
Right now, he is talking on slide number 3, but the slide is stuck with number 1 itself.
Number 1 only.
Ji, you make it as a. Yeah, you are right. Now only you clicked it.
Okay. Is it.
No, not yet. It has not gone to the full slide show.
Sir, let it be like this only. We are able to see slide number 4 as of now.
Okay. This is the slide. I think you all are seeing this slide in which the primer has been applied. Okay, so.
Shall we upload the slides, Shika, from here?
Yes, ma'am, please go ahead.
Yeah, Hemanji, can you just withdraw your slides? We will upload your slides here. You can only talk. Yeah. Please withdraw your slides, we'll upload.
Yes.
Version that is what Dr. Ved Lakshmi has already shown. So, I think, are you getting the slide?
Yeah, it's visible. It's in slideshow mode also.
Yeah. So, G, we are in slide number 3. You want to talk on slide number 3 or 4?
Yeah, I think this is the first slide in which the rusted bar is shown. which is the first. This is the first node. The robot has to be treated after this. So after this, the blasting is done to the rod. Can you move it to the next, please? Yeah. In this case, blasting is shown to be done to the rods. The rods have to be turned about 3 times for the blasting to be done efficiently. Sand is shot on the sand or slag. It is shot on the surface so as to, at a pressure at about 6 kg per centimeter square, to remove all the rust and also to prepare the surface for the primer. Can we go to the next one? Okay. In this slide, we can see that the primer has been applied. The primer is applied at a thickness of about 50 to 75 micron, dry film thickness. This is applied coating or crushing. This is the final coat that has been applied. Final coat is applied after about half an hour after the primer has been applied. Because since the resin is based on thermoplastic acrylic, it dries very fast. So because the drying is very fast, the second coat can be applied within half an hour's time. So any time after half an hour, the second coat can be applied. Total thickness of the coating is about 125 to 175 microns. Go to the next one, please. Okay, here we can see that the bars have been cut and bent. So we can see that due to the flexibility of the coating, the bars can be cut and bent in any desired shape. Here, this is one of our sites, which is the dedicated freight corridor. This is the project from Vaitarna to Surat. We were doing this for Soma Enterprise Limited, and this is one of the sites where the bars have been cut and tied, and we can see that there is almost no damage to the coated bars. Okay. This is the part of the same project. This is a massive project which is going on throughout India, and this is again part of the same project where we were involved in. This is the exhibition at Pragati Maidan in Delhi in 2010, which we were honored to be part of. Here we can see the Director General of CSIR, Professor Brahmachari, and Shri Kapil Sibal, who was a minister at that time, and I was also there. So this is when we had presented our rods, etc. Can we go to the next screen, please? Okay, here we are going to explain about the can we go to the next attachment, please?
We have only this many slides, sir, which you sent.
Yes, yes, there is another attachment also.
Shall we move ahead?
Yes, sir. Okay. These are basically a few of the slides that I think Dr. Vedlakshmi had also shown, in which she has demonstrated that the bond strength between the concrete and the steel is not affected when a coating is applied, because the coating itself is applied at an optimum level, which is not too thin and not too thick. So the bond strength between cement, between the concrete and the steel is not affected to any great degree. And it is a very fast curing coating. So the turnaround time is very fast. That is, we can coat the bars and use it within a day's time with the full process. Thank you. Okay, these are a few of the jobs that we have been involved in our career. First one is the Santa Cruz Chembur link project. Then we've been involved in the Mundra port. Then we've done certain jobs in Orissa. And again, the DFCC project in Gujarat. RVNL projects in Orissa. Then the Vasai Creek Bridge for the railways. The East-West National Highway project for Sipav Engineering. We've done one of the projects for L&T for the Kandla Mundra road project. So we are proud to have been associated with many prestigious projects, and we hope that shall continue working. Thank you, everybody, for your time.
Thank you very much, Hemang Gabishurkar ji, for your talk. So we'll move to our next speaker, Shri S. Shahul Hamid, who is proprietor of Protectol Anticorrosives Chennai. Mr. Hamid is a graduate in mechanical engineering and works basically in the field of coatings and anti-corrosive products. His company, Protectol Anticorrosives, is associated with CSIR SICRI and the CPCC technology since 2003. And with the proficiency of the work, they have utilized this technology in treating for more than 1 lakh ton of steel for various projects. So we'll now listen to our next collaborator, Shri Shahul Hamid ji. Over to you, please.
Hello, good afternoon to all. Thanks, Dr. Shika, for the nice introduction. Respected Dr. Kalei Selvi, Director CECRI, Dr. Vedalakshmi, Senior Principal Scientist, and my co-panelist, Mr. Hemang Vijurkar, and the viewers. Thanks for giving the opportunity to participate in this webinar. As the webinar is organized in commemoration of the selection of CECRI's rebar coating CPCC technology as one of the success stories of CSIR Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, 80 years, 80 success stories. I am indeed very proud that I am a licensee of this successful technology developed by the great institution. And it's a great privilege and honor to be here. Now I will start sharing my presentation. The main focus of the webinar, rebar anti-corrosive coating system, CPCC, cement polymer composite coating technology developed by CECRI. I am Shahul Hamid, proprietor of Protectol Anticorrosives, a licensee of this technology, and I propose to give a brief presentation about our association with CECRI and my experiences and insights in implementing this technology. My entrepreneurial journey started with my getting technology know-how from CECRI for anti-corrosive treatment process some 32 years back in the year 1989. Actually, that time when I was interested to get into business, I had a chance meeting with the CECRI scientist in an entrepreneurial development program conducted by my alma mater, College of Engineering, Indy, Chennai, where I did my mechanical engineering. That meeting developed interest towards CECRI technologies. Subsequently, I visited CECRI Karaikudi and had discussion with the scientists. And upon their advice, I got a technology know-how for anti-corrosive treatment for steel reinforcement rods through National Research Development Corporation, NRDC, and my business career started in the reinforcement corrosion field. That also satisfied my eagerness to do something that is more innovative and challenging, that solves some perennial problems. Also, collaborating with a world-renowned research institution brought a sense of achievement. That is the beginning of our company, Protectol Anticorrosives, in the year 1989. When CECRI developed the advanced technology, CPCC, cement polymer composite coating, in the 90s, we got the technology know-how in the year 2003. In fact, it was a great leap for our company, no doubt. And we were, in fact, very excited that being a small industry, we are handling a world-class technology developed indigenously. In later years, we have also obtained technology know-hows from CECRI for other processes in corrosion control as well. Now, actually, what is CPCC coating? It is an on-site corrosion protection treatment for steel reinforcement rods used in concretes by means of coating the rebars with a specially formulated rapid setting anti-corrosive primer and top coated with a cement polymer sealing coat. Now, let us see how it is applied. Briefly, the application involves cleaning of the rods, apply 1 quart of primer, allow to dry for 30 minutes, apply the sealer top coat, allow to cure for 6 hours. The coating is completed and the rods ready to be used. Let me give you a brief about the implementation of the technology. Now, in construction sites, this is a common site. We can see the rods being stocked like this, and we will be coating these rods. Now, after having taken the technology know-how, it is our part as an industry to bring the technology to the practical implementation use in construction sites. As far as the rebar coating is concerned, though it looks like what is a big deal, it's just a paint, it's not. In fact, the site conditions will be quite overwhelming to say the least, some of which I have summarized. We will be dealing with round surface of varying diameters piled up, intricate surface profiles, ribs of varying designs, plain, rounded, etc. Fabrication of coated bars like cutting, bending, etc. Inevitable rough handling of coated rebars by workmen. We can't blame them. Practically, it is not possible to handle lightly. The time taken to get the rods coated, we cannot hold up the progress of work because of rebar coating readiness. Now, let us see how CPCC technology answers these issues. The coating can be applied by dipping or brushing. The coating flows well through surface profiles. It's flexible, that is to say, the coated bars can be bent. The coating withstands normal handling stresses. It has got rapid setting property. That is, the primer sets in 30 minutes and the top coat sealer can be given, and in another 6 hours, the coated rebars ready to be used. This helps in planning and execution at short notice. Hence, there will be no adverse effect in construction progress. Now, let me share some pictures taken at site. Here, we can see coated rebars handling, lifting, tying, fabricated bars, rings, stacking, etc. Here, we can see the coated rods getting ready to be used. Now, let's see what kind of projects we have offered CPCC coating. We have offered CPCC products to various projects throughout India. I have just given overview of the kinds of projects we have used. It's used in railway bridges, highways, IT parks, housing projects, metro rail construction, power plant construction, construction of chimneys, etc. Now, I will share some pictures of the projects where our products of CPCC are used. Here, we can see the coated rods utilized in construction and power plant chimneys under construction, etc. Here, we can see some pictures of the coated rods being used in construction. Now, let me get into our long-term commitment to CPCC technology. After taking the technology know-how in the year 2003, we have renewed our license agreements twice, that is in the year 2010 and 2017. And we hope to renew our license further and stay connected to this technology in the years to come. Having been associated with CECRI for so many years, I have witnessed the great efforts put in by CECRI scientists in bringing out marketable technologies useful to the society, at the same time viable commercially for the licensee. I wish that CECRI brings out more such successful technologies in the coming years. I thank CECRI and CSIR for giving me the opportunity. Thank you one and all for your attention. Thank you very much. Now I will move.
Thank you very much, Rahul Hamid ji, for your talk and for your wishes. And also, grand wishes from our side for your grand collaboration with Sikri. So, sure, we will have many more collaborations of such kind.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Thank you again.
Thank you.
So, thank you all for sharing your experience on this technology and your coordination with CSIR Sikri. So, now we keep this forum open for a discussion among the speakers and the stakeholders. And I shall take few questions also from our viewers. So, I think we have a question. Dr. Vishnu Priya, she is connected with us from CSIR CCMB. She is appreciating our work and she is requesting to please throw light on public awareness on these quoted applications for common uses. Dr. Kalai Selvi, ma'am, if you can comment on this.
Yeah, coming to public awareness, actually, we are conducting a number of industrial conclaves and industry meets. And especially one of the clients, that is MNG, he showed in India International Science Festival, wherever we have this kind of scientific expo is arranged, and wherever industrial conclaves are there, we do demonstrate this kind of technologies, and we just get one stall and we just try to explain. And this is what we normally make this as the platform to reach these people. In addition, in CSIR Sikri itself, we have one council called NCCI, National Corrosion Council of India. So through this NCCI, it's a non-profit, it's a society. So through this NCCI, normally we conduct number of programs. We arrange workshops, we arrange seminars, conferences, and recently we conducted an international conference also. So this kind of participation, this kind of arrangements from our side is happening. We do participate in NACE conferences also. So everywhere our scientists, they travel across the country and they meet ministry, they meet industries, and they attend this kind of seminars. And this is how we are trying our level best to give awareness to the public. Apart from that, our website is there from which you can get some information. And maybe if at all you have better suggestions to reach the general public to create awareness, we are there to do. And one more thing, Dr. Shika, many times we arrange some kind of awareness programs also, maybe in the nearby places, nearby towns, villages and cities, wherein we meet even common man and we try to explain them how and all we are trying our level best to mitigate corrosion, especially the fisherman boat and all, how best they can apply simple techniques by means of which the coating life could be enhanced. So that also we are giving some kind of a hands-on experience, hands-on training to such people. We do approach, we do reach the society through our skill development program that is known to you. So through the skill development program, we are addressing different age set of people, maybe school dropouts, then school completed, college completed, diploma holders, ITI holders, then industries also. Of course, we handhold some paint industries and we go to nearby educational institutions and we offer them 2 weeks training program and we give them two big walls wherein they can play around with the kind of paints also. Like that, we are trying our level best.
Okay. Ma'am, I have some technical question. So is Sikri doing some kind of corrosion monitoring also before applying?
Yeah. Definitely. Actually, we are doing a number of monitoring related attempts we are doing. We are doing it through sensors. So we have developed some embedded sensors. These embedded sensors will be kept in structures. See, for example, if it is a Kudankulam nuclear power plant. So there, whatever it may be the place you want to analyze whether the structure is safe, the structural health of the structure, if you want to know, you cannot do it on all the days. 365 days, you will not have access to all parts of this nuclear power plant. Whereas, if you just keep one embedded sensor over there, then you can really monitor it. This is one. Right. And another thing is, we recently come up with some kind of an ICMS gadget, where we integrated the corrosion monitoring sensors as one gadget. And through this gadget, by sitting in your place, by sitting anywhere in the world, you can really monitor how corrosion is taking place and what is the rate at which corrosion is taking place and how best you can really have a control over the system. That is also happening. And Shika, I will tell you one more thing. Recently, including Dr. Vedalakshmi, one team worked on one kind of a coating, which we call it as triboluminescent coating. Meaning is, this coating, if at all you apply just at the bottom of the bridges, then this particular triboluminescent coating, whenever this heavy vehicle trucks and all are passing over the bridge, if the bridge is maybe 50 year old or no, old or more, then if you want to really certify whether the bridge is really having eligibility to admit for several more years, or this is high time you should stop all the heavy trucks crossing over the bridge. In such case, this kind of a triboluminescent coating helps you. The moment you apply the triboluminescent coating at the bottom of the bridge, and when this kind of a mechanical stress is given on the bridge due to this overload, this will develop crack. This developed crack will make your component, that is your triboluminescent material, that will give you some kind of a fluorescence. So it will be coming there for about 1 or 2 seconds. But we will fix camera to just capture this kind of a signal. And by image processing, by sitting in anywhere, in your lab or in your office or at home, then you can understand where the crack occurs at an initial point, and what is the direction in which the crack is propagating, what is the depth of the crack. So all these things you can understand. So when you are able to monitor, do this kind of a remote monitoring, then you can say that if this is happening in this way, definitely within another 6 months or so, you should advise that this bridge should no longer be utilized. So that kind of technology is also there. So there, I think if at all somebody is interested, we will just do the last mile coverage and we will make it as an applicable mode. So that also we are doing.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So it's very good to know about the monitoring technology as well. And one more question I have. Does the composition or concentration of this kind of coatings varies with the type of a structure?
You will be the right person to answer. Yeah.
No, madam.
These are standards.
It is standard.
Standards. Yeah. Further, I wanted to know about the life of the coating, but from your presentation, I came to know it goes around 80 to 100 years.
Shika, shall I come in for a minute?
Yes,
this is what I told, but then only I realized I was under mute at that time. Once I called my scientist, the working team, and I asked him, what is the life of your coating? You know, with great boldness, he said that, madam, life of the structure is the life of my coating. I asked him, is it an exaggerated version? No. Then next day, he came with Dr. Vedalakshmi. They showed this graph. So this graph clearly says that it is not an exaggerated version, because normally any structure, the service life is 75 to 100 years. So by applying this coating, you are enhancing the life from 15 years to 75 years. So life of the coating is life of the structure. Yes.
Yeah. So we have another question from our viewer, Avijit Ghosh. What type of cement is used in the coating? OPC, PPC or PSC?
Ordinary Portland cement. Because due to hydration, that is the chemical reaction between the sealer coat as well as with the concrete, which will improve the adhesion, the bond strength of the concrete, basically. Okay. This cement is having a higher hydration reaction when compared to other cements like Bosolana cement and slag cements. So we preferred only ordinary Portland cement, which improves the bond strength.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So another question there. How is this coating done? Spray coating or some other technique used for coating?
It is normally recommended dipping only, widely practiced because it is outside process. So dipping is more preferred. Threshing as well as shopping, shop coating also we can do.
Does it cause any kind of damage to the environment? Does this kind of coatings cause any kind of pollution to the environment? Is there any study on that?
Pollution. Effect on the environment.
It is only we are using admissible solvent only. The VOC also permits is as per international standard. It is also which is limited. Hamid, can you tell something about this? Have you got?
When you say VOC, it is a compound.
Yeah.
Hamidji, I think you may say
that is if you have any monitoring of VOC at site. When doing a large quantity of steel rebars, sir.
No, you have to unmute.
You are, please unmute.
Actually, we are using solvents, okay, aromatic solvents for mixing and other things, thinners. There will be some VOC content, but the site is very vast, but it's not, we should not do it in an enclosed atmosphere. The sites are all big projects, it's all open area. So these are, if it is used in open area, the concentration become very less. But it should not be used in the enclosed area, like a shed. If you put and apply, the concentration will be more. So that has to be taken care. And also future, SECRI also has to develop green solvents instead of just polluting solvents. All the next development can be, it can be reduced.
Sure.
Yes.
Thank you very much. So I think we are done with the questions from you viewers, and we are reaching to the end of this session. Thank you everyone once again. It was really great listening to all the speakers and stakeholders today, and was interesting to know about the cement polymer composite coating technology developed by CSIR SECRI. It was really very fascinating to know about its application in the Pamban Bridge, as Dr. Kalai Selvi said in the beginning, in Rameshwaram. Definitely the place has been visited by many of us, but very few of us know about this technology used for making these bridges stand for years together. So I'm very sure there should be many other places where structures based on this CPCC coating rebars are standing and are acting as the building block for the structures. So thank you everyone once again.
Thank you.
I request Dr. Kalai Selvi once again, Director CSIR SECRI, for delivering the closing remarks for the session. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Shika. Once again, my heartfelt thanks to my CSIR parent organization, and to Shika, to Githawani, and Director General Dr. Shekasi Mande. First of all, you have given us an opportunity through this forum, by means of which we are now able to reach these many people today. And today, I really enjoyed the show thoroughly. And this has given us, because now Sahulji has given us a very good assignment, even though we were thinking, and it is there in a very preliminary stage. Now we know that if we really make it as a technology, Sahulji himself will take up it as a technology. And therefore, we are getting encouraged with this kind of a feedback. Definitely, your point is well taken. We will just make it as version 3.0. And we will give it to you only, sir. We will do it permanently, certainly. And Shika, because you are talking about, because somebody has raised a very valid point, its effect on environment. We from Chemical Research Institute, whatever we do, no, end of the day, we should ensure that it is not at all giving any harmful effect to the environment. That's why now our CSIR has now given us a huge funding to come up with LIB making technology, indigenous LIB making technology, by means of which we will be supporting e-mobility in the country. And therefore, we are playing a very, very vital role in making clean India, green India, because one of the major sustainable development goal of this government of India is energy to all, power to all, clean energy and green energy. So we are making all these things to happen. And the other thing is, the main aim of this institution is how best we can really do justice and help the nation to protect the metal wealth of this nation and the material wealth of this nation. So when it comes to the, because most of us, we never knew that the country is abundantly blessed by nature. We are abundantly blessed with lot amount of resources for metal, and we are rich with materials also. So how best we can really have a very good control over protecting the metal wealth and the material wealth. This is where these corrosion mitigation technologies and corrosion monitoring technologies are coming into effect. The more you mitigate corrosion, the more you are giving a great saving to this nation. And people like our clients like Hamid G and Hemant G, they talked about tonnage of steel that they have really protected from corrosion using this particular technology. So similarly, we are coming up with a number of other technology in the area of even metallurgy. And when we talk about metallurgy, here also they are applying it over rebar only. And especially with respect to metallurgy also, we are having number of unique technologies. And one is called electrochemical salt winning technology, molten salt winning technology. And we are coming up these days with the eco-benign chrome plating also. So like that, if you just say coating in SECRI, we have number of coating, whether it is a thermal barrier coating or super hydrophobic coating, intelligent coating, smart coating, you name any coating, we are there. So as long as the country is giving this kind of importance to protect the metal as well as material wealth of this nation, we are having a very, very safe travel, and we are getting all of our requirements addressed, both from the client side as well as from the parent organization. And my sincere thanks to CSIR as well as our potential clients. So it's a mutual success for both of us. Because of them, we are feeling so proud. Because of our technology, they are feeling so proud. So thanks for showcasing this kind of a win-win situation. to all the viewers. Thank you, Shika. Thank you, Hemantji. Thank you, Hemantji. And thank you, Dr. Vedalakshmi, and my planning and my business head, and my Sikri family, I should say. Thank you, one and all. Namaskar.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Namaskar to all.